If I scan this QR code, my GoPro will automatically start recording as soon as I take off. And if I scan this QR code, it becomes a motion detection camera. Now these are only two of the heaps of extra features these QR codes can do, and in this video I'm going to show the most useful ones for FPV pilots. Alright, so what even are these QR codes and how do I get them to work? Good question. GoPro has a beta program called Labs for features that never made it into a stock camera. To use it, go to GoPro Labs GitHub and download the file for your GoPro. Extract it and put the file called update in the root directory of your SD card. Check that your battery is above 50%, then chuck the SD card in and power it on. Take several minutes to update, and that's it. Before we even get into special settings, the best thing about this is you can change regular camera settings to either the website or a phone app. I'm gonna put all the settings that I use for FPV in here. Then, I'm gonna go to the camera, scan it into register. On top of being able to change every little camera setting you want, you can also precisely set the date and time to within a second. Now into all the special features. Now this first one is one that absolutely everybody should use. It doesn't matter if you fly drones or not, just everybody that has a GoPro should be using this feature. So it's pretty simple. Lines 1, 2, and 3, just write in whatever information you want. Scan your QR code. And now when you power your GoPro on, it looks like this. So now if you lose your GoPro in the bottom of a lake and somebody finds it 10 years later, they'll know who to contact. Now we move outside. This is where it starts to get really fun. Next one is motion detection. Sort of like a trail cam where you just set it up and when it sees motion, it starts recording. And when the motion stops, it stops recording. You could use it as a trail cam, put it in your fridge to see who's stealing all your food. Or the one that I want to use it for is put it on your drone. I think this will be really good for automatically recording when you take off. So let's test that out. ND16 on here. That's all the settings I'm using. And that's gone. Okay, this should be recording right now. Oh yeah, that's nice. Now let's see if it stops recording automatically. And it worked just perfectly. I would say that is probably one of the best ways to start and stop recording reliably. All right, now this next feature is pretty similar. So this time it uses the gyrometer and accelerometer to detect motion. When it detects that it's moving, it'll start recording instead of just going by what the camera sees. And that is also really good for recording when you take off, probably even better. For that, we're gonna go also into the motion, but we're gonna switch it to the gyro plus accelerometer. Delay start by 5 seconds, I guess. Hold time 3 seconds, yeah, that's fine. Start sensitivity. We want this to be on the higher end, so probably like a 7. The stop should be pretty low, so probably like a 3. That should be good, we will see. Settings still good, still got some battery left. Let's go. And if everything went as planned, we should be recording right now. I hate landing when it's windy. Right. How long does it take to stop recording? And it stopped recording. Perfect. It started recording and the rotors turned on basically. About a second before takeoff. That's pretty good. And this next feature will make it start recording when you plug the USB power in. With a bit of delay. And it'll stop recording as soon as you lose the USB power. This feature would be really useful if you had like a naked GoPro on a cinewhoop or something and was wired directly to the flight controller. And as soon as you plug your battery in, the GoPro will power up and start recording. All right, now another cool feature which would also work for this is sound pressure level trigger. That basically uses the camera's microphone, and when the estimated sound pressure level gets above a certain number, it'll start recording. When it gets below that, it'll stop recording. So my thought is if we can figure out about how loud the propellers are when we arm the quad, then it should start recording. And when we disarm the quad, it'll stop recording. Let's see if that works. Start sensitivity. Ooh, how loud is this thing? I have no idea. So these are the settings I put in. Even the beeping when it starts up might activate it. It did. Let's see how this one works. Should be recording. That should definitely be recording. That's loud ass. This cinewhoop is insanely loud. The parameters I set should definitely be recording now. My voice sounds funny right now, it's because like, my nose is being squished by the goggles. Yeah. Oh. Well, that was a good landing.
Let's see, when does it stop recording?
Okay, those are definitely good parameters. That one's really good though. I feel like that one could be one of the most reliable ones. And the next new feature is being able to start and stop your recording based on the GPS speed. I haven't really played around with this much, so see how this goes. There's definitely a lot of use cases. where you don't want it to start recording until you get to a much higher speed, like if you're racing cars or something, you just want it to start recording when you're actually doing it, going really fast, like 300k an hour or something. So this is the settings I'm going to use, and then scan the QR code. Now I can stick on the drone and go fly it. In case you're wondering, this is the bandit-proof mount that I got recently. Really good, I've crashed it a lot and it's held up really well. Nice. I'll put it on a different post because I don't want to take off right next to my head. Let's see if it works. And let's go. No idea if it'll work. There's an angle. Oh, now it's an air mode. Okay, that was weird. Started off an angle. Alright, should be going now. Power lines. What in the world? Telemetry lost. It just cut out. Battery strap got cut. And then, why did I lose video? Positive power cable popped off. That's why I completely lost everything. Let's hope that the GoPro was recording, because that was crazy. Conclusion is, maybe using the GPS of all things on here to determine if your GoPro is going to be recording or not is not a good idea, okay? It's just a terrible idea. Yeah, don't do it. I crashed and you have no idea that I crashed. Nothing recorded it because of the GPS. You can't even see an antenna on here for GPS. It's going to be somewhere inside that circuit board. It doesn't pick up satellites very well, so yeah, I probably don't recommend that. All right, what features next? Let's see. Have you ever lent out your GoPro to someone and instead of taking videos, they accidentally took photos the whole time? With archive mode enabled, both buttons do the exact same thing, start and stop recording. You can't change any settings, you can't mess anything up, just video. Have you ever had it where you're trying to stabilize an FPV clip, but right as you're about to dive off that waterfall, it splits it into a second file? Well, with larger chapter support, that will be no longer. If you have an SD card that's at least 64 gigabytes, with this QR code, you can increase their chapter size to 12 gigabytes. 12 gigabyte chapters actually stand on GoPro's Hero 11 to 13, so I don't need to scan this. But if you have something older than that, this can be a good way to increase that. Editing 4K and 5K footage can be really demanding on your editing software. The only way to work around that is to use what's called a proxy file. Basically, you render a much lower resolution version of the exact same clip, you edit with the lower quality footage, and then it automatically syncs it up with the high quality footage when you render it. And the problem is, it takes absolutely forever. And if you have a whole heap of clips, it can literally take you days to render it all. Now, GoPro actually saves lower quality versions of every video you shoot and calls them LRVs. So wouldn't it be great if you could just use that for your proxy file? Turns out with Labs, you can. They've added an extension to produce Adobe Premiere Pro or DaVinci style proxy files instead of having to do it itself. So now instead of just calling LRV files, it'll now name them the exact way that either Premiere Pro or DaVinci Resolve would like them to be named. Let's try it out. And now we have a folder called Proxy. You see, it's much lower quality. Bit fuzzy. And guess what? It's already got proxy lined up. Well, see, very fuzzy. Already picked up the proxy. I didn't even have to right click and link anything. It literally just picked up that there was a folder called proxy in the same area and it took the proxy just like that. Very easy. So that's nice. When I'm shooting in my FPV settings, I have my ISO and shutter speed locked. When you're out vlogging or something, you're definitely not using those exact settings. And sometimes it's nice to know exactly what your ISO or what your shutter speed is at. And when that is set to auto, your GoPro doesn't show that at all. But with Labs, there's a way. EXPS equals 1. And you take this, scan. ISO 101, shutter 1 over 121. So I currently have this locked at ISO 100, shutter 120, but it's actually shutter 121. Interesting. If I change the settings to something else, it's now very different. ISO is now 1600. So I currently have an ND filter on, so it's barely taking in any light. ISO is all the way up at 1600. Check that out. So that's just something nice to be able to see what it likes to sit at. Let's say you manage to crash your drone so hard that either the battery comes out or the SD card comes out somehow, and you lose 20 seconds of your footage, and you don't even get to see the crash. Fortunately, Labs again has you covered. Increase write frequency, you can write to it faster so that it's only a few seconds versus 15 or 20 seconds. But here's how I'm going to test it out. So I'm going to record a stopwatch on the computer, I'm going to pull the battery out, and I'm going to check on the footage and see how much actually got saved to the SD card. Without increased write frequency, it stopped recording at 16 seconds, which means it lost 14 seconds of footage. With increased write frequency, it stopped at 28 seconds, which means it only lost 2 seconds of footage. If you crash your drone, that is crucial. That means you get all the way up into basically when you crash. Whereas without that extension, you're gonna miss even the lead up to it. So if you're an FPV pilot or anything like that, this is definitely one to use. Next thing I'm gonna try out is increased bitrate. So changing bitrate, the high bitrate, usually it's 114 megabytes per second. We're gonna change this up to 180 megabytes per second. See if it's better quality. See if it even records at all. If you have your GoPro in a case like this, you really can't see the back screen, which is a shame because all the labs messages are shown on the back screen. However, labs has a way to fix itself. If I scan this QR code, all the messages will now show on the front screen, like this. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you go check out this one next, because YouTube's pretty sure you're going to enjoy it. As always, thank you for watching this video, I'll see you next time.